Hello everyone, today I'm going to tell you about how to do self-threading. Initially it's not going to be easy, but with practice you will be becoming perfect. Usually people use the threading wand, which is this. With this also you will be able to shape your eyebrows, and the other one is the tweezers, which will come handy for you. And both of these instruments can be used to shape your eyebrows. So let's get started to the self-threading process. So this is the one which I'm using, which is used for threading, and this you can get in any of the cosmetic stores. Take small length of thread until here, and this is the length which we will be needing for the threading, approximately 30 centimeters. And so I'm going to tie a knot. Once you have tied a knot, the thread will look like this. Okay, so okay, it depends on your convenience, whatever length that you want to take. So I'll be using a length which is, you know, convenient for me. Twist one side of the thread about 6 times. Okay, try to tie your hair. We don't want the hair to be distracting us, so I will be tying my hair completely. Make sure there are no strands which might distract you in the process. So firstly, take a scissor and cut both the ends, first ends of the eyebrows. And with the threading thread, the ones which you have already twisted. First, I'm starting off with my left eyebrow. For this process, you have to have this in a bigger part, and this should be the smaller one. From the smaller one, we will be tweezing to the bigger one. First start off with the ends of the eyebrows and then come to the other end. If you can cut little bit of hair from here, you will be able to get the shape. Please be very careful that you don't cut your skin in this process. If you see, I almost got my shape for the left eyebrow. And I'm going with the upper part. If you see, I got the shape for the left one. Now let's get started with the right one. Again, please twist thread for 6 times. Start off with the other eyebrow. As I said, we have to start from the last end. There are high chances that your eyes will water and you will have pain, but it is still bearable. If you are not able to, then please refrain from doing this. To give the shape, please ensure that you are cutting here. I got the shape. And now I will go with the upper part of the eyebrow. If you see, I got the shape for the other eyebrow as well. You always have to make sure that the knot which is there should be to the end. Let me just show you here. So if the thread is like this, the knot is here and I have to start twisting from the other end for 6 times, and that you have to ensure the thread, the knot is always towards this end. And it should never come in between, because it will distract. It may not give you the correct shape, and also there are high chances that you may not be able to do the threading. It will take time to get the perfection, but I'm sure that you will be able to reach with the practice. So we are just done with the threading, and if you see, my eyebrows are in perfect shape, and so I often use this when I don't have time to go to parlor, and if there is any sudden occasion I don't have time, and I do the self threading for about 5 to 7 minutes, and that is how, you know, it looks. It completely gives out the shape as a parlor for me. But I would recommend that practice will only make you perfect. Please be very careful in the process, because there are high chances that you may cut your skin doing this, because even with me it happens often, because we cannot really stretch this. Some people you know, take too much of time, you know, stretching it, which will apply a stress here and it might give you headache. So it is very important that, you know, you don't stress your nerves. And I also often do my upper lip. This also gives me the perfect look. I don't have to do any waxing. I don't have to use any cream to remove my hair there. I just have to do the same threading technique. So I hope you find this video helpful, and please give it a thumbs up if you have liked the video.